Yeah, I actually decided to beef up my water preps because when it comes to emergency preparation, there's really nothing more important than water. And speaking of which, I saw this movie called The Way Back, starring Ed Harris as an American who went to Russia during the Great Depression, but ended up in a Soviet camp in Siberia. Well, he teams up with some other prisoners, this crazy hardcore Russian who has no problem stabbing people. A really nice guy, a really nice Polish guy, and an array of other characters who are fairly likable, and they basically decide to leave the camp, escape from the camp in the middle of a blizzard and go south through the Himalayas, okay? They actually decide to go south to safety, to freedom in a non-communist area. This is during World War II, and this movie is fascinating because they go through really cold tundra climate area. They go through sort of a really thick forest, and then they go through a desert, and water became really, really important. They actually come across a really interesting character that sort of shakes up the dynamic between the guys, and I really recommend this movie. It's available on Netflix Instance. And then, man, water. This movie encouraged me to beef up my water preps. You can't have too much water, so take a look at it. Yeah, a lot of you guys have seen some of the water I stored up, but I decided to get some more. I also want to put them at different locations throughout the house so that it's more readily available. Yeah, in addition to the case that I put near the stairway, I also bought two more. I'm probably going to put one downstairs, the other one somewhere upstairs. Some of the things I decided to go with, so it'll be a good idea to put some snacks in there, you know, so lift morale if there's some type of crisis. Yeah, I love these things, and you know, again, morale, lots of fiber. A lot of people don't like these because they have their GMO cans, as some people say, but you know, if it really is a crisis situation, you know, it'll be helpful to eat the things that you actually like to eat. And frankly, I don't think you're going to be that picky. This stuff is really good. The sausage and the sardines, you know, the thing about these two items is that you can just open them up and just start eating. You can do the same thing with the soup as well. Of course, spam, you know, a little less sodium, some tuna. And this is just another new area of food I'm working on. Actually, I decided to put some of the water in the red container along with some of the extra items simply because I like to cover up my water. I like to protect it from the sunlight. I want to discourage any type of growth. I just want to keep it protected and put it in a pretty dark place. I decided to actually move some of the DVDs out of the way and put some food in a drawer until I find a better location. And there really is no perfect way of doing this. But, you know, anything's better than nothing. Put the sleeping bag in there. I have a little additional bag right here. I don't even know if this thing will close. Wow, I did. Kind of. You know, I actually came up with a really strange idea. I figured since I'm going to actually store water in a place where it's going to be dark, you know, why not have it in a mobile location, somewhere where I can just move it? So it'll be easier to move it out of the way and move it to the areas I want it to go to. It has four wheels on it. Yeah, I'm not going to try to put three in there, but I like the mobility. So yeah, I could be more organized, but you know, as long as you can find where things are, you should be all right. You don't need a really intense database or anything like that. Although some people prefer that, and you know, that's all right. Some people have thrown around some ideas of running drills in their houses where they turn off the electricity in their house for 24 or 48 hours. I wouldn't recommend that because you don't want to interrupt the lives of people in your house. I understand you want to be better prepared, but you don't want people in your family thinking that you're crazy. So a lot of stuff is prepping. A lot of stuff is just stuff I would have anyway, the ammunition. The tools, basic tools for the car and for around the house, and the ammunition and the various liquids and fluids I would actually need, and some more tools back there, nails and stuff like that. But yeah, this is pretty much my utility closet. All right, guys, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. So don't forget your water. I already have a filter, a water filter. And that's going to help me avoid drinking some contaminated water, because drinking contaminated water can kill you very quickly as well. But I also need to get some more water purifiers. So you'll see more on that.
Now, as many of you guys know, I have a portable water filter, but I'm also starting to store up some water purification tablets. Now, the way these tablets work is, well, essentially you take one tablet, put it in 1 liter of water, and let it sit for 4 hours. It's supposed to kill the germs, get rid of the viruses and the bacteria and other stuff, and make it actually drinkable. Now, I actually discovered I had a set of tablets right here. One would actually neutralize the germs, another one would actually remove the actual sort of like iodine type of taste from the water. So I thought that was pretty cool. Nice combination. I'm gonna get a lot more of this stuff. I also, you know, this filter, this part goes right into the water, the creek water, and I use this, hook it up to the top, and it just pumps this thing, and it pumps out filtered water. So pretty cool. I'm gonna put this back in my bug out bag or emergency bag, and I'm gonna actually put this in a whole military can. And I'm just gonna have like a whole can filled with filters and purifiers. It's gonna be pretty cool. This book is so addictive. I got this at the library. I decided to buy my own version. Okay, I want to have my own copy. This is that good. I can't wait to start talking about this book. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.